Believers, this is a quick video for the 21-day challenge, and I told you guys to clean out your cupboard, and now I'm going to tell you what you do need in your cupboard. You know, you've gone through your pots and pans, and now you've gone through all your pantry, and you know what you need to get rid of. This is going to be a quick video about what spices you need to have in your cupboard to have a clean eating kitchen. Now, up here I have sea salt. This is rock salt. I use my Mozart pestle and crack it up. I got these, four of these from IKEA for like $2. And here I have thyme, my Mozart pestle. This one's for my kitchen only. So this one, they come with a really cool, like little shelf you can put it in, but I have such a really cool cabinet, I don't need it. So here's a thyme. You're going to need, this is black pepper, sorry, fresh crackled black pepper. This is cumin, this is onion powder, garlic powder. You can have cayenne pepper, you don't absolutely need it, but you can have it. I have it because, well, I'm still Jamaican even if I'm clean eating, so we still have our Jamaican spices. Oregano, this is rosemary. I like to get this one as well as the fresh one. Red pepper flakes, absolutely essential. Chili powder. This is more black pepper. I have fennel seeds. Fennel is really, really good for helping you control your appetite. So these are organic fennel seeds, and you just crush them a little and add them to your meal. Whole cloves. Sage. This is ground sage. This is parsley. I have Mrs. Dash because Mrs. Dash is really good to add to everything. And this is basil. And then I have my Jamaican seasonings. I have jerk seasoning. This is fish seasoning. There's another jerk seasoning. I also have a wet jerk seasoning, but that stays in the fridge. This is paprika. These are just extra spices that my dad gave me. I also keep table salt. I don't really use it, but you need to have it. You can add it every once in a while. These are fresh nutmeg that I get from Jamaica. I've had these for a couple of years now. As long as they stay in their outer shell, they're good. You just crack them when you need them. And I very rarely use them, but they're really good to have. Cinnamon is also essential in a clean eating kitchen. And these are my whole black peppers. I have bay leaves back there. I have adobo seasoning. Whenever I cook my best friend's pork, her way of cooking pork is using adobo and some sazon. I have browning, and this is curry. Curry is good in a good clean eating kitchen. And I have soy sauce and more bay leaves. Oh. I'm gonna just put these back. But those are just extras up there. Baking powder, more cinnamon. And the reason I'm showing you this is right after I issued the 21-day challenge, I went and got the Clean Eating magazine and the new Clean Eating magazine for this month, January, February, and they had how to set up your clean eating kitchen. And in March, April issue, they're going to have how to set up your clean eating fridge. So I hope by then we'll have gotten there. But this is now your kitchen, and this is what your spice cabinet should look like and have. And we are going to go over, I'm going to show you a video of my other cupboard. Go over what you can get, and these are cheap. I get these in the little baggies for 69 cents at our local price, right? and I get their flavor version for like the basics. I very rarely get like the ground stuff organic because that makes no sense. To me, it doesn't. It makes no sense to pay all that money for ground up organic stuff unless you're doing it yourself when you buy, when you go and get. I'm multi-time principal. There you go. And you can always have a bigger mortar and pestle or whatever, but I liked this one. It was, the kitchen store near us was closing, so I got it for like $2. But this is just a quick view of my spice cabinet. Up here, I have legumes, all my beans, and my spice soup sauces up here. And these are all leftover cans. I don't drink coffee, but friends drink coffee, so I tell them to save them. And I just put this. This is a really good mix right here for making soup. So I keep it together. You know, all your different beans in here are kept up there. And then on my counter, I have more beans. Pastas, whole wheat pastas, and then this cabinet has all my teas. This is mint right here. This is mint we grew. We have echinacea tea. These are my organic teas, and then I have canned produce up here, and that's all my baking stuff up top. But I got this as a gift, so that's there. That is a gift. That's a gingerbread. But you know, getting a lot of these are all glass. I get these at IKEA. My mom gave me the ones with the wood. This one's from IKEA, and I got it from like a dollar something. But keeping your produce in glass, not produce, your legumes and your spices in glass will help them store longer. If you keep them in a cool, dark place like my spice cabinet, they can last for up to a year in the glass jars. This is honey that I got from Jamaica. Isn't it beautiful? But yeah, just try and switch your stuff out from plastic, and I'll do a video about which plastics are good and which plastics you should get rid of. But thanks for watching, and blessings.